Welcome to Bowling 101. Today, Professor DeRubis is going to take us through the complete anatomical analysis of bowling in four different phases.
The preparatory phase begins with the bowler standing in a comfortable position.
Their feet are spaced about a half a foot away from each other with the left foot slightly in front of the right foot. The knees are slightly bent, and the body is fairly straight with the waist and the back straight. The right arm is in a flexion position at the elbow, and the bowling ball is in this hand. The elbow and the shoulder should be aligned with the shoulder directly over the elbow. The forearm should be in a supination position. The left arm should be in a flexion position as well. The left arm is also slightly adducted across the transverse plane of the body, in which the left hand is underneath the right arm's wrist, cupping the right wrist. This is to help support the weight of the ball and keep the right arm aligned properly.
This brings us to our next phase, in the backswing.
To begin the backswing, the bowler will take a step with their right leg forward. At the same time, they will push the bowling ball straight out in front of them, putting their shoulders in flexion through the sagittal plane. Once the ball is out in front of the bowler, they will release the left hand and let gravity take the ball down. As this is happening, the bowler will also be taking another step with their left leg. Momentum should now be serving as a pendulum, and it should take the ball up behind the bowler, so the bowler's shoulder is now in extension. When this occurs, the left arm should adduct straight out to the side on the frontal plane with the elbow extended. At this time, the bowler will take another step with their right leg.
Now that we have completed phase 2, we can talk about phase 3, the downswing.
In the downswing, the right arm should continue on the path of the pendulum. When the right arm comes back down the path it came up, the bowler should be taking another step with their left foot. This is the final step of their approach. Throughout this phase, the right arm should still be aligned from the shoulder, elbow, and the bowling ball. The right arm should still be in supination with the arm slightly flexed at the elbow. Also during this phase, the left arm will stay abducted from the body in the frontal plane. Now we are ready for the final step, the follow-through phase. In the follow-through phase, the bowler will be sliding on their left foot. All their body weight will be placed on this foot. To counterbalance the weight put on the left foot and the pendulum movement of the ball in the right arm, the bowler will have to abduct the right leg behind the body. The bowler will then place this leg on the ground, still keeping all their weight on the left foot. Their hips should be in flexion with their back straight. There should also be a slight rotation to the torso of the body. The bowler's left arm will still be abducted in this phase. This too will help counterbalance the weight of the ball and all the weight put on the left foot. The right arm will still be moving in the sagittal plane, and the bowler will release the ball when it gets just past their waist. As the ball is being released, the bowler will flex their phalanges as well as the wrist flexors in their forearm. This will increase the rate at which the ball will spin on the oil of the lane, otherwise known as RPMs. So when the ball gets to a dry spot on the lane, it will in fact increase its speed. Also, the bowler will pronate their wrist slightly, approximately to the neutral position of the forearm. This will help produce a proper rotation on the ball, which will work with the RPMs I just mentioned. The right arm should now be in flexion at both the elbow and the shoulder, with the arm above their head. Throughout this phase, the right arm should stay aligned from the shoulder, elbow, and the wrist. If everything is done correctly throughout these four phases, and the bowler hits their mark, the ball should find the pocket, hopefully producing a strike.
I hope you enjoyed this step-by-step anatomical analysis by Ernie DeRubis. Take it in and use it to get that perfect strike.